three things in one. She's artist, she's historian, and she's educator. And as an artist, she has done a lot of exhibitions in all over the world, from New York, the United States, and Canada, and Germany, and so on, and so on. And I'm really excited about your talk now. Please, Bahia, start your talk.
I'm quite honored to have my teachers and my students in the same room. This is a great feeling for me, and this is another beautiful teaching. I think I've given this presentation from a historic perspective, and I'm really excited to share it with the Thai design community to see their take on this project. This project has really changed my life. So I was invited to participate in an exhibition in 2010, and 1,000 times more was the idea I proposed. So I looked on a lot of Islamic artifacts, and I started looking for the Lam-Alif. I collected my findings in a book, and what was really important is the research, but also the artwork as it stood. And the house was seeing these 1,000 different signatures of Noam together was really a source of power for me. I want to take you now through the history of the project, so I will share with you the evolution of one letter that means Noam in Arabic. So this is the 7th, 8th century Common Era, and or the 1st and 2nd century Hijri. You can see that how the script, I think around the examples in the book there are others, but for the source, for the reason to be brief, I selected a few. So this is 1st century, quite naive, still primitive experimentation. This is 3rd century. The first one was on dinar, so on coins, so I was sure that the date is true. These were actually on tombstones in Cairo, and that was on a plate in Shabu. This is also 3rd century, but these are all on the same tombstone. This is an experimentation by Mubarak al-Maki, and this is at the Islamic Museum in Cairo. It's a very small stone plate, but these experimentations of the Lam-Alif were done by one artist on a very small piece of stone. Please keep this in mind, because you will see where this will go soon. So that was a small plate. This is the nanometer, and you can see how brilliantly represents the script. It's very formal, and it's very clear and strong, or very clear, interesting movie. So this is still the 3rd century, usually 9th century. And the 4th century, we start seeing experimentation on different materials. So this is on fabric, this is on pottery. This is also on plates, and the last one is on the Quran. And you can see how the designers are starting to think with the shape of the script and play around with it a little bit. This is 4th century at Hakimov in Cairo. If you go down to my street, you can see this on the walls of the mosque. So the interesting experimentations that you were seeing in the 3rd century on a small piece of stone, now we're seeing relatively similar way of thinking, essentially later on the royal building. This is a 10th century, 11th century, the Common Era, and here I am not in Iran. This is an example of not only it's painted, but this is a simplification. 11th century, there is more creativity, it's quite logical because the empire is growing, there's more. Expansion, so the other examples are all on manuscripts, so they're all on Qurans. And the lower examples, this is a coin, this is stucco, and that is pottery, and the last two are also stucco from Afghanistan, from Iran, from Cairo. So there's a lot of details in the research that where these regions are coming. So again, 12th century, we're still moving on in history. You can see Again, the top ones are on manuscripts and the lower ones are on different materials. So the experimentation and the creativity and the solution for this one letter is nothing but, to me, is amazing. In the 12th century, this happens in Cairo. This is painted at the Maqam al-Khulafa' al-Abbasiyyin. So this is a painting in a dome. What happens next is very interesting because a century later, the same logic is applied in Konya on tiles. So it's the same logic of knotting, very elaborate, very interesting. And then for the Mamluks, the concept that we probably discuss now as old and dying, the Mamluks were already playing with these ideas of very old scripts and very light scripts in the 13th century. In the 13th century, also the square pocket becomes fashionable. They start covering buildings across the Islamic world. 14th century, there's a bit more experimentation. This is in Cairo on marble, and in different also in Turkey, in different parts of the Empire. But you can see from now on how we are back to the basic two shapes. This is 15th century, and the Lam-Alif is within the basic two forms, the open one and the closed one. And this is where the downhill, obviously the Islamic Empire is shrinking. You can see it clearly in the script, so 16th century, 17th century, 18th century, 19th century. And then the computer comes and comments the ugly bold fonts are in the fashion version. And this is what we look like right now. Really, this is what we look like. So, after all the creativity that I saw, this is what I find in the computer. And to me, it's there are two. It's shocking. It's sad. It's I don't know. It's a mixture of feelings. But after everything that we saw in the past 14th century, this is where we are right now. I'm not saying that this is only it. There are some adaptations that I think are translations. There are some trying to come up with more solutions, as I said with that, but I think there needs to be a lot more done in terms of developing. We need more experimentation. I think what we need is more creativity in terms of looking at Arabic. I was quite hesitant to present the second part, as I didn't see it as relevant, but I will be sharing what happened with the Lam-Alif for you. This is a very personal journey. So after this exhibition, the revolution started, and for some reason, I started spraying the law on the street, so the law started finding the life of its own, so not to military rule, not to burning books, not to stripping the people. And I started painting the laws on the street as a way of me to connect history with the in terms of the script itself. And then this happened. Cairo clean now. So I can't express that on the streets in Cairo anymore. I'm not only speaking of the political agenda, but I'm also speaking of creative expression. And I thought that the street is a good place to be if you want to express creatively and connecting people. So I decided to go elsewhere. So I went to Germany. In Cairo, I started spraying law on the streets all around Cairo. I also went to New Orleans to paint Nome on the street on the streets of New Orleans. But then the Nome started getting redundant, and I said, okay, I've said no a lot, so what's new? Well, how can we express now with something other than rejection? So, and I discovered that from 1982 till about 2000, around 13 Arab poets committed suicide. And that is a good indicator of a nation. So I decided to start painting poetry around the world. So I picked a Palestinian poet, Mahmoud Darwish, and I started painting his works in different cities around the world this year. So the first one I painted was in Vancouver, in Canada. It was كيف على مصر بتحكي مقاطي. You can see from I also said the challenge is for me to create something visually new every time I paint. I didn't want to repeat the archaic forms, but I wanted to develop on the shape of this. So, and this one is a kind of experimentation of a broken script. This was in New York, and it was a poem about the imprisoned butterflies. But still, I was really not very satisfied since this is more like a zoomorphic experiment. So the next one was Madison, and the poem was Lebanon's Bahia, not the impossible. And I started creating the triangular grid to create a very complex form of Lam-Alif and a slightly simpler typography underneath. This was in Beirut, it was covered. I'm going again next week. So, welcome to Habiba, and I worked with the design of small bags for the script. It was just, I thought it was fun. This is in Malawi, and I'm really glad that the students who helped me painted are actually in the room today. So, thank you for coming all the way from Malawi. نحن محب الحياة إذا ما استطعنا إليها سبيلا. And what I did is I decided to work only with four modules. Two rectangles, a square, and a circle, and that's it. I wanted to create all the letters out of four the geometric modules, and this came out. And then in Tokyo, I wanted something that would reflect the spirit of Tokyo, so I created this script. It's called Tokyo. It's a round script. And the poem is على هذه الأرض ما يستحق الحياة. As you can see, legibility is not my priority because I'm interested in play. Being playful and experimenting with the limits of Arabic. So how can we push Arabic to its limits beyond legibility? The last one I'm sharing today was painted in Catalonia thanks to my good friends. And it was painted for the Syrian refugees who are drowning at sea. And the poem is من لا بل له لا محلة.
This is Quran on parchment, and it's extremely